Hello students, welcome to Narayana online class. My name is Rahul and today we are going to discuss questions on calorimetry. So let's start the discussion. First question, a lead piece of mass 25 grams. So we'll convert this mass into kg, 0.025 kg. Calorie is given. So this Q is given in calories. So we'll convert this joule and this temperature is given. So delta T is 80. Okay, use the formula Q is equals to ms delta T. From here we have to get s, so s will be Q by m delta T. Just substitute the value, students, we'll get s as 2520 joule per kg per Kelvin. Now we need to get student C. So this thermal capacity C will be equals to ms. Yes, substitute the value of m and s. M is this and s is this. Substitute the value. We'll get the answer as 63 joule per Kelvin. That will be the answer of this question. Third, we have to find water equivalent W. W will be equals to this 63 by this, the water equivalent value. Just divide it by K, the water equivalent value 4200, that will be equals to, this value is 4200, so this value will be coming 0.015, and that will be the answer of this question. Let's move to the next question, student. Here the specific heat capacities of substance are given as this. Okay, so here it is variable specific heat capacity. We need to find the amount of heat required. So Q we need to find. So Q, it's a variable specific heat capacity. So it will be integral T1 to T2. This 3 theta square plus theta into 10 to the power minus 3. This is for S into M. M value is substitute. It is M is given as 1 kg. So it will be 10,000 kg. Okay, just do the integration of this one. So integration, it's pretty simple. This 3 and this 3 will cancel out, and here we have theta square by 2. Put the limit of integration. A limit of integration will be from 10 to 20 to 1000, right? Solve this, you will get the answer as 7150 joule. That will be the answer of this question. So let's move to the next question. Here we have to find the water equivalent. So water equivalent W, if we have to find, it will be ms. Just substitute the value 200 into 0.09 and it will come as 18, and that will be the answer of this question. Let's move to the next question, student. Two spheres of radii in the ratio this 1 is to 2, their specific heat capacities are given in the ratio. So S1 and S2 ratios are given as 2 by 3. Okay, R1 by R2 ratio is given as 1 by 2. And rho 1 by rho 2 ratio is given as 3 by 4. So again, pretty simple question. We have this type of question, ratio based question is asked in exam. So whenever we have such type of question, we'll just take the ratio as it is and just be careful whether it is given the ratio of R1 by R2 or it's R2 by R1. So we'll substitute here. So mass can be written as density into volume. So rho 1 into volume, 4 by 3 pi R1 cube, right? By rho 2 into 4 by 3 pi R2 cube into S1 and here by S2. So if you simplify this, 4 by 3 pi, 4 by 3 pi will cancel out. Here we are left with rho 1 by rho 2 into R1 by R2 whole cube, right, into S1 by S2. And we are given with these values. So just do the substitution here, rho 1 by rho 2. If we do the substitution this side, rho 1 by rho 2 is 3 by 4, R1 by R2 cube. So it will be 1 by 8. And we have S1 by S2, so it will be 2 by 3. If you simplify all this, it will come as 1 by 16. Just cancel this to this, 3 and 3 cancel, so we'll get 1 by 16 as the answer. So the ratio of their thermal capacities will be 1 by 16, and that is the answer of this question. So let's move to the next question, student. 10 liter of hot water at 70 degrees Celsius is mixed with an equal volume of cold water, and the resultant temperature is 20 degree. Okay, so here we have to find the resultant temperature. Directly, if you know the result, you can use this T resultant. It will be equals to M1 S1 T1 plus M2 S2 T2 by M1 S1 plus M2 S2. Those who are wondering how we get this result, just do one thing. Let the resultant temperature be T. Find the temperature difference. So the temperature difference will be M1 S1. Let T be the higher temperature. So T minus this 70 plus M2 S2. Let this be higher again than this 20. So it will be T minus 20. So this will be total heat exchange, and since no heat is exchanged in the surrounding, we can equate this with zero. So if we equate this with zero, and if you solve here, T value you have to solve. So when you will solve for this T value, it will be coming as M1 S1 T1 M1 S1 T1 plus M2 S2 T2 by M1 plus M1 S1 plus M2 S2, right? So just equate these two value, you will get the resultant. What we have done, we have taken the common temperature to be higher than both 70 and 20 degree. So here the net heat loss, one will lose the heat, one will gain the heat. Okay, so this heat exchange, I have taken the net as in one side, and this side it will be zero because no heat is lost in the surrounding, so it will be zero. So if we equate this, we will get the T resultant as this only. Now this question is pretty simple. If you get this formula, just substitute the value here. M1 S1 T1 is given to be 70 degree Celsius, and T2 is given as 20 degree Celsius. So here T1 is given as 70 degree and T2 is given as 20 degree. The resultant temperature you have to find. So this will be given. Now specific heat of water is given. So S1, S2 is also given, and 10 liter of hot water is mixed with equal volume. So this M is also given. So M1, M2 both are equal. Just substitute the value here. T resultant on this formula, if you substitute, you will get the answer as 45 degree Celsius, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, so let's move to the next question. A sphere of aluminium is placed for sufficient time in a vessel. So we have a sphere of aluminium like this, and it is placed in a vessel containing boiling water. So this, when placed, this is a sphere of aluminium, and it is placed in vessel of boiling water. It is then immediately transferred to a copper calorimeter. Okay, so whatever will be the heat, because here the system heat energy will be conserved, and if you apply the principle of calorimetry, according to principle of calorimetry, heat lost by body 1 will be equal to heat gain by the body 2. So if we do this, if we find what will be the net heat exchange when sulfur of this is placed, so we find the heat exchange by the sulfur, heat exchange by aluminium. Aluminium sphere, heat exchange by aluminium sphere, just find this value MS delta T, and that will be the heat exchanged by this vessel plus this calorimeter, this vessel plus heat exchanged by this calorimeter. So just equate this two value here, heat exchange by the vessel. What will be the heat exchange by the vessel? It will be there. It is then immediately transferred to 0.14 kg of copper calorimeter containing 0.25 kg of water at 20 degree Celsius. The temperature rises and attain a steady state at 23 degree. Calculate the specific heat. So here the steady state temperature is given as 23 degree Celsius. So we'll take that as a temperature difference here. Okay, so heat exchange by this, just substitute here the value 0.047 into specific heat of aluminium we have to find, SAL we have to find, and delta T will do it from 100 minus 23. Okay, now this side, it is then immediately transferred into a copper calorimeter. So here the temperature difference is 0.25 kg of water at 20 degree Celsius. So here this 20 and this 23, so that will be the temperature difference for this vessel, and we have to find it for this calorimeter again, the temperature difference. So use here m1 s1 delta T plus m2 s2 delta T. Just substitute the two values here and equate the two energy. So when you will equate the two energy, S aluminium you will get as 911 joule per Kelvin. So whatever we are doing here, heat lost by one body, we are applying the principle of calorimetry simple. Heat exchange by the aluminium sphere is this, we equate with the total heat exchange by the vessel and this calorimeter. Okay, and that will be the answer of this question. So let's move to the next question. The temperature of equal mass of two different liquid A, B and C are given. So we are given with TA as 12 degrees, TB as 19 degree and TC as 28 degree. Okay, the common temperature of this TA and TB, so when A and B are mixed, when A and B are mixed, student, when A and B are mixed, the common temperature is said to be 16. Common temperature, this is the common temperature. So whatever heat exchange, again principle of calorimetry can be applied here. So whatever heat exchange by the first body, they are having equal mass, right? Three different liquids of equal mass. So M SA into T, here the difference is 16 minus 12 for this A side, and here this M into SB into, here the temperature difference is 19 minus 16. So here we get SA by SB ratio. SA by SB ratio will be coming as, here we are getting 3 by 4. Similarly, when B and C students are mixed, when B and C are mixed, they get the resultant as 23 degree. So again we can find SB by SC ratio. So we find SB by SC ratio, and if you solve it, it will be coming as 4 by 5. Okay, so SA by SB ratio we got, SB by SC ratio we got. Now they are asking what should be the common temperature when A and C are mixed. So when A and C are mixed, so from these two, what we can get? From these two, we can get the relation between SA and SC. Let this as equation 1, this as equation 2. So from here, we can get SA is equals to 15 by 16 SC. From here, we are getting SA is equals to 15 by 16 SC. Now, when A and C are mixed, student, when A and C are mixed, when A and C are mixed, what we can write? Again, M S A T, will take the common temperature, and A is at 12 degree. So T minus 12 will be equals to M S C. We are taking this as, say we are taking this as, this is 28, so we are taking 28 minus T. Heat exchange by heat gain is equals to heat loss, we are doing it. So MM again cancelled out, we are getting here SA by SC, which will be equals to 28 minus t by t minus 12, and SA and SC value already we got it. Okay, so from here SA and SC value we can substitute. Here 15 by 16 it is. So from here if you simplify, T will be coming as 20.22 degrees Celsius, and that will be the answer of this question. Right? Substitute SA and SC value, which we already got from the previous by comparing the two SA and SC. So this will be the answer of this question. So the resultant temperature will be 20.2 degrees Celsius. Let's move to the next question. Students, here the melting point of ice is 0 degree Celsius. At what pressure it will be minus 1 degree Celsius? So it is a simple question of melting of ice. We just equate the value delta P by delta T, and L is the specific heat value given by V2 minus V1. V2 by V1 is directly given to us. So just, and here the delta, here the T is given as 1 degree. So when you substitute here the values, V2 minus V1, L by T, V2 minus V1 you can write directly from the question given, 0.9 into 10 to power minus 3. Okay, L and T, we can just check the here the temperature change, we can find it here 1 degree, and here L value you can substitute. When you simplify, here delta P is coming as 110.8 atm. Okay, now just many students leave here in this step and they check for the answer. Here they are asking at what pressure will it be minus 1 degree Celsius. So here they are asking you, here it is P2 minus P1, it is given as 110.8. P2 they are asking. So P2 will be this plus 1. So the answer of this will be 111.8, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, so delta P, don't left this answer here in this step and mark this, because one option will be given for that also. So let's move to the next question. Students, here a piece of ice of mass 100 gram and temperature 0 degree Celsius is put into 200 gram of this. How much ice melt you have to find? Okay, so here principle of calorimetry, if you apply according to principle, by principle of calorimetry, heat loss by body 1 will be equals to heat gain by body 2. So just substitute here the value, here because ice is melting, and here how much ice it is melting to reach the temperature, here we have to find. So first find here Q will just substitute the values here. Q is equals to ms delta T. If you substitute, Q value will get as 21,000 joule. Now you have to find how much will be the ice melt. So Q is, this Q is the heat given by the first body, and this must be equated with the heat given by the second body. So this will be equated with ml. Okay, m we have to find it here, so it will be m Q by L. Just substitute the values here, we'll get the m value as 62 gram, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, so simple energy conservation we are doing, heat energy is conserved in the previous, in the two process, and that will be the answer. Let's move to the next question. Here students, the graph is given and the change of state is happening from 1 gram of ice at minus 20 degree Celsius, and it is converting into this at 100 degree. The steps are given here. Now here if you see, from Q1 to Q2 there will be rise in temperature. So we'll use MS delta T. Okay, S value we'll use because here it is ice is given. So use this S of ice, S ice here, and delta T we can use it from here to here we are getting. So here this ice will come to 0 degree. From minus 20 it will come to 0 degree. Okay. So here this Q1 will get, if you substitute the value 1 gram and this, will get as 10.6 calorie. Okay. Now this ice at 0 degrees Celsius will change its state. So here Q2 will be the change of state for this one here. So Q2 will be ml, and just substitute the value here, we'll get as 80 calorie. Now again from C to D, if you find here C to D, again there will be rise in temperature, and if you substitute here M S delta T, now this time it will be from 0 to here the temperature difference will be 100. Okay, so here this temperature difference, if you substitute here, the value will get as 100 calorie. That is for Q3. Now again in Q4 state, there will be a change of state. So Q4 will be M into LV, that is change of state for this T. Okay, so when you substitute the value of Q3, it will, you will get as 539 calorie. So what is the net exchange they are asking? So Q net will be equals to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. If you substitute the values here, so 10.6 plus 80 plus 100 plus 539, this will add to 729 calorie, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, so just see here, first there will be temperature change, then there will be phase change, then again temperature change, and again phase change. So just add all the energy, you will get the answer of this question. Let's move to the next question, students. A calorimeter of water equivalent 83.7 kg contains 0.48 kg of water at 35 degree. How much of ice at 0 degree Celsius should be added to decrease the temperature of calorimeter to 20 degree? So you want to decrease this temperature to 20 degree Celsius. So by principle of calorimeter, by principle of calorimetry, whatever is the heat loss by ice is equals to heat gain by this water plus calorimeter system. So let's calculate first heat exchange by water plus calorimeter system. What will be the heat exchange by this water plus calorimeter system? So it will be Ms delta T, M1 S1 delta T plus M2 S2 delta T. So just substitute the values here, 83.72 into S, S is given as 4186. Into delta T will be 15, plus here we have 0.48, this is for the water, into 4186 into again 15. So if you solve this, this Q value is coming to be 52.869. Okay, now similarly we'll find the heat required by the ice to come to 20 degree Celsius, heat required by ice. So we'll find that, so that will be equals to QL plus MS delta T. So if you find that, just equate this to energy, you will get the value of M. Okay, here it will be ML plus MS delta T. So if you equate this, the heat which we got from Q1 and this we got from Q2, if we equate the two heat, Q1 is equals to Q2, Q2, you will get the mass required by the ice to just, how much mass of ice should be added so that the temperature decrease by this volume. So just find here, just substitute the value, we'll get the answer. It will be coming around 12.62 kg, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, so let's move to the next question. A steam at 100 degree is passed into 1 kg of water contained in a calorimeter of water equivalent 0.2 kg at 9 degree. So you need to find the mass of the steam. So let the mass of steam be M. Let the mass of steam be M. So if we have m as the mass of steam. Now heat required by this, heat required by this steam plus this calorimeter should be equated with the heat required by this will be equals to heat gain here by the other system. Okay, by principle of calorimetry we can do it, right? Heat required by this should be equated here with this heat exchange, heat gain here. So if we equate the heat required and heat gain here, what we can find here? So m into, let 540 plus ms delta t, just equate here the s values here, so it will be m into 1 into delta t here, it will be 100 minus 90, because here the steam will be at this temperature and it is increased to this. So this will be my heat exchange by first system. This I named it as Q1. Okay, now we have to find the mass of steam condensed when this water and this calorimeter, we take them as a system. So first find the heat exchange by that system. So heat absorbed by water plus calorimeter system, what will be the heat absorbed by this water plus calorimeter system? It can be written as, because it can be written as Q2. So just equate this Q2. Q2 will be 1000 into 1, and we can take this delta T as common. So we take delta T plus, this will be ML delta T plus, we can find it here for 200, that is for 0.2 kg. So we have converted this 200 into 1, and delta T here it will be 90. So 1000 into 1, that will be 1200. Directly we can write it as 1200, and outside we have 90, right? So 1200 into this 90, delta T will be 90 here. So just 90 and delta T, 90 minus 9, sorry, this will be my delta T, right? So just equate here, Q1 is equated with Q2. So equate Q1 and Q2 here. You have to calculate the value of M. So just equate M into 540 plus 10M will be equated here with 1200 into, this will be 81. So solve for here the value of M. M will be coming as 0.18, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, again we have used the principle of calorimetry, students. We equated the two value, heat exchange by this system, and we equated the heat exchange, heat absorbed by water and this calorimeter system. Whatever heat this steam will exchange, that will be absorbed here by this water plus calorimeter system to increase the temperature initially from this to this. So delta T, we have just taken the value 90 minus 9. Okay, be careful on the calculation part in such type of question. So let's move to the next question. Here 1 kg of steam at 100 degree Celsius is passed into a vessel of 1 kg of ice at 0 degree Celsius. You have to find the equilibrium composition of the mixture. So here we need to find the equilibrium composition of mixture. So when steam and ice are mixed here, in steam if we are adding ice, what will be the equilibrium composition? So heat exchange we first find out. So what will be the heat exchange by the steam? So it will be M into L. So just substitute the value, you will get Q1 as 540. Okay, now heat exchange by the ice we find. So M ice plus this M water, MS delta T we are using. So when we use this, we get 180 calorie of heat is required here. Okay, so let, you have to find the composition now. So let M be the steam condensed. So if m is the steam condense, so we can write m into 180 is equals to 540 calorie, right? So from here we can write m as 540 by 180. So this much will be my steam condensed. Okay, so 1 by 3 gram will be my steam condensed here. So this steam condensed into water. So what will be the water composition here? So it will be water composition if I write here. So water will be 1 plus 1 by 3, and if I write steam composition here, it will be 1 minus 1 by 3. That will be my steam composition here, because that much of the steam will decrease. So we can write here it will be 4 by 3, and it, if you decrease here, it will be 2 by 3, right? That will be the answer here. So let's move to the next question, student. So here if you see, the next question is, six grams of steam at 100 degree is mixed with 6 grams of ice at 0 degree. You have to find how much is the left steam left uncondensed. So again we'll find the composition heat exchange when steam is heat exchange by the steam. This is the heat exchange by steam. So it will be m into s, m into ls. So just simplify this, it will be coming as 3240. Just substitute the values here, it will be coming as 3240. Now this is the heat exchange by the ice. So heat exchange by the ice will be equals to m into l, that will be change for the phase change, plus this will be the heat exchange for the temperature change. So this, if you substitute here, the value is coming to be 1080. Okay, this value is coming to be 1080. Now if you see here, what we have to do, let m be the mass of heat, m be the mass of steam form. Okay, so if m is the mass of steam form, steam condense here, so from here what we can write, if m is the mass of steam condense, so it will be m into that 540 will be equal to 1080, because this much will be the heat taken from here. So from here if we find it here, the m value is coming as, if we simplify this, m value will come as, simplify 1080 by 540, that will be the amount of heat exchange here. Okay, so m will be coming here. So how much is this, this much amount of steam is left, so just find it, subtract it from the total. Okay, so if you substitute here, it will be coming as 2 grams of steam is condensed. So how much is left uncondensed? So left uncondensed will be 6 minus 2, that will be 4 grams, and that will be the answer of this question. Let's move to the next question, student. Here a piece of ice at 2100 calorie and latent heat is given as 3.36 into 10 to the power 5 of m mass is given at minus 5 degrees Celsius. It is given that 420 joule of heat is required for this ice to melt. Now finally, when ice and water mixture is in equilibrium, it is found that 1 gram of ice has melted. So here, like the previous problem, we find that this much amount of ice has melted. You have to find what will be the heat exchange, and there is no heat exchange given in the system. So you have to find what will be the amount of ice that was present. So let m be the mass of ice. Just equate this with the total heat given here, 420. So m into s delta t is equated here with ml. So just equate here, you will get the value of m. So m value here, if you simplify, m will be coming around 8. So check the answer here. M value, what will be coming at it? M value will be coming around to be 8 gram. And that will be the answer of this question. Okay, simply heat exchange we have equated. Okay, that is the answer of this question. So let's move to the next question. When small ice crystal is placed into a super cooled water instantaneously, what is the amount of ice formed when 1 kg of water super cooled to minus 8 degree Celsius? So here you have to find again the heat lost by body will be equals to heat gain. So ML will be equated with MS delta T. Okay. So ML will be equated with MS delta T. Just simplify the value here. You have to find for M. What is the amount of ice melt? M will be coming around 100 gram. Just equate the values. L and S is the standard value which you have to take. It is not given in the question. So just take the values. You will get M as 100 gram. And that will be the answer of this question. Okay. So let's move to the next question. A piece of ice at 0 degree is dropped into water at 0 degree. So here what is given, we have a water at 0 degree and we just drop an ice here in this water. Okay, you have to find how much ice melt, then ice will melt will be converted into water, not melt or partially melt. That is what you have to find. So here, if you see here, heat exchange here, what for heat exchange, there should be temperature difference. Okay, for heat exchange, there should be temperature difference. And here, there is no temperature difference. Okay, so there is no temperature difference. So there will be no melting of ice. There will be no melting of ice because there is no temperature difference between the two systems. And since there is no temperature difference, there will be no melting of ice here. So no melting will be the answer of this question. Students, two liquid A and B are at 30 degree and 20 degree respectively. When they are mixed in equal masses, the ratio of their specific heat you have to calculate. Okay, so here we have to find the ratio of their specific heat. When they are mixed, they are found to be 26 degrees Celsius. Okay. So what we do, we know that the resultant temperature T can be written as M1 S1 MST plus M2 S2 T2 by M1 S1 plus M2 S2, right? So here T, the resultant temperature of this mixture is given. Okay, two liquid A and B are respectively, they are mixed in equal masses. So M can be cancelled out here. Here this T1, T2, if you look here, T1, T2 value is given. T1, T2 and T values are given. The ratio of their specific heat you have to calculate. So means S1 by S2 you have to solve. So just substitute the values here. 26 will be equals to S1. S1 is, we'll keep add S1 as it is, and T1 is 30 plus S2 into T2 is 20 by S1 plus S2. Simplify this here. 26 S1 plus 26 S2 will be equals to 30 S1 plus 20 S2. Okay. So simplify here. It will be 28 S1 will be equals to 6 S2. Right. 28. Here we have 26 S1. 26 S1 is equals to. So here we have 26 S1 is equals to. So if we simplify here, we are getting 6 S2 is equals to 4 S1. Yes. So we will get here 4 S1. So from here we have to get the ratio of S1 by S2. So S1 by S2 will be 4 by 6 and that will be equals to 2 by 3. Right? So 2 by 3 will be the answer of this question. Just check the calculation part. 26 S1 plus 26 S2 will be equals to, this is 30 S1 plus 20 S2. So what we have done? We have done here 4 S1 and here 6 S2. So S1 by S2 we have to find. So S1 by S2 just we have to check carefully. S1 by S2 will be equals to 6 by 4, right? So just check the calculation. 6 S2 is equals to 6 S1, 4 S1. So from here we are getting 6 S1 by S2 will be 6 by 4 and we will get the answer as 3 by 2 and that will be the answer of this question. Right? So be careful on the calculation part, simply we have to equate the two temperature and we will get the answer. So let's move to the next question. Here we have a beaker containing 200 gram of water. The heat capacity of the beaker is equals to 20 gram of water. The initial temperature is 20 degree Celsius. 440 gram of hot water at 92 degree Celsius is poured into this beaker. So what is given here? Heat lost by the hot water. There will be some heat lost by hot water and this will be equal to heat gain by cold water plus heat exchange by the beaker. Okay, so that we'll take into consideration. So if you see here, heat lost by the cold water, we can write M L delta T will be equated here. M1 L1 delta T1 is equated to M2 L2 delta T plus for this beaker M3 L3 delta T. Okay, so if you see here, what will be the mass given for hot water? So just substitute here 440 into L. L value will be the heat exchange for the water, so it will be same. L value heat capacity is of the beaker is equal to 20 gram. Heat capacity of beaker, this L3 is given as 20 gram, other than this it will be 1 into 92 minus T. Okay, 92 because it's a hot water, so it will exchange this, the temperature will go down. It will be equals to M2, this is for now cold water. So cold water is 200 gram. So 200 into 1 into this, what is the temperature here? So both are at temperature 20 degree, right? So the initial temperature of water in the beaker will be 20 degrees. So we'll take that delta T as common only. Okay. So it will be T minus 20 plus now we have 20 gram, this as 20 gram. Okay. So 20 gram of this into this M S delta T. Just substitute this and delta T value. Delta T will be again T minus 20. So if we simplify this, we have to get the value of T. If we simplify this, we can get the value of T as 68 degree and that will be the answer of this question. Okay. Just take this L, L value can be cancelled from the both sides. Okay. So that will be the answer of this question. That is the common temperature. Let's move to the next question, student. Here a 10 gram of ice at 0 degree is mixed with 10 gram of water at 100 degree. Okay, so the final temperature of the mixture you have to find. Okay, so let T be the final temperature. So if T is the final temperature, first the ice will melt, there will be change of state, so ML. So just take that into consideration, we will get this. Now you have to for then there will be a change of temperature, so ms delta t, when we will take that ms delta t, we will get 10 t. Substitute the values, m are given, s value we can substitute, is equated with here 10 gram of water at 100 degree Celsius. So 10 gram of water m w s into 100 minus t. So if you solve this, we are getting as the total value of this is coming to be, just simplify this one. So it will be 20 T is equals to 200. So T will be coming as 10 degree, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay. So just equate again. Here we have used the principle of calorimetry only. Heat exchange we have equated, right? And that is the answer of this question. So let's move to the next question. Here three liquids of mass m1 and m2, m3 are mixed with this. So you have to find the resultant temperature. Let T be the resultant temperature. Okay, so heat exchange for the first one, first body, it will be equals to m1 s1, and it will be t minus theta 1. Similarly, heat exchange by the second one, we can write it will be m2 s2 t minus theta 2. Similarly, heat exchange by the third one, heat exchange by third body, it will be m3 s3 t minus theta 3. Okay. Now the total, I have taken the T to be in higher side. So the total exchange here, it will be lost and there will be no exchange of heat. So it will be equal to 0. So this, if we add m1 s1 t minus theta 1 plus m2 s2 t minus theta 2 plus m3 s3 t minus theta 3 is equated with 0. Okay, we have to get the value of T here. So if you solve for T, it will be coming as m1, just simplify this, m1 s1 t1 m1 s1 theta 1 plus m2 s2 theta 2 plus m3 s3 theta 3 by, it will be coming as m1 s1 plus m2 s2 plus m3 s3, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay, so this is the answer of the question. Let's move to the next question, and this is the last question for today. Three liquid A, B and C of mass 400 grams, 600 grams and 800 grams are given when A and B are mixed. So already we have done such type of question when A and B are mixed. So when A and B are mixed, we have to equate their SA and SB. Okay. So MA SA into delta T will be equals to MB SB and delta T. Right. So you have to find the ratio of their specific heat when they are mixed. A and B are mixed, 36 is the resultant temperature. So here, if you write here, it will be 36 minus 30. This will be, just write it, MA into SA, and here it will be 36 minus 30. Okay. And their masses are also given. So just substitute here the value 400 into SA into 6 is equals to MB. MB is given as 600 into SB, and delta T, here delta T will be 40 minus 36. So from here, SA by SB, we can find it. That will be 600 into, just be careful on the calculation part, by 400 into 6. Okay. So this will come as 100 and this will come as 100. So this will be 1 by 1. Just check the calculation carefully. Resultant A and B are mixed at 36 degree. Okay. A is at 30 degree and B is at 40 degree. So this is what we have done. 36 minus 30 is equals to 40 minus 36. Similarly, when B and C are mixed, when B and C are mixed, MB, SB, right? And delta S, the resultant is 44. So 44 minus 40. 44 minus 40 is my resultant. It is equated with MC, SC and delta T. What is delta T here? 50 minus 44. Okay, just substitute now the MB value. MB value is 600 into SB, and here we have 4 is equals to MC. MC value is 800 into SC, and here this is coming as 6, right? So SB by SC will be coming as 800 SB by SC. So 800 into 6 by 600 into 4. Be careful on the calculation part. So this will be 1 and this will be 2. So this ratio is coming as 2 by 1. So SA is to, you have to find the ratio of SA is to SB is to SC. We got the value as 2 SA by SB. If you equate this, SA, just take the reciprocal of this one. SA is to SB is to SC. If you equate, we will get the value as 2 is to 2 is to 1, and that will be the answer of this question. Okay. So students, here we come to the end of today's discussion. If you revise all the concept, I hope you get a good clarity of the whole topic. So that's all for today. Thank you.